Hey, it's Karina Gordon-Barnes of youinspireme.co.uk. And we're looking today at content marketing and how you decide what kind of content to share in your blog, if you do videos like this, if you do a podcast, if you share anything on social media. So we've got all these opportunities these days to be content creators. And yet we can have this feeling, okay, so I've got a YouTube channel, I've got a blog, I've got a Facebook account, a Twitter account, I'm a content creator, but what content can I actually put out there that's going to be interesting to people and that's going to lead to clients, which would be the point of doing content marketing through your business. So the way that I like to think about it, it's one way, is to think about the kind of journey that you take clients on through your paid for products and services. And then your content marketing can replicate that kind of journey. So I'll give a couple of examples to share what I mean. So for example, one of the key things that my courses do, the journey that people go on when they take one of my training courses online, is it's around clarity. It's around the step-by-step, getting clarity, things becoming easier, things making more sense. That's the journey that I offer. And so through the content that I share through my blogs, for example, then my intention is to make things clearer, step by step, easier to understand, to give people light bulb moments and to feel like, oh, actually I can do this. So I'm just replicating that same energy that someone would get if they actually worked with me on a paid for basis. And I'm putting that energy into the content that I share for free. So that's one example from my business. Another example, let's say that you're a massage therapist and you know that when people come to you for paid for massages, they are taken on a journey from stress to calm. Okay, that's your equivalent of that journey, from stress to calm. So how could you share free content, blogs, videos, etc., that mirror that same journey of stress to calm? And so it could be the first thing that comes to mind is that you could share, for example, on your Facebook page, very calming images. Or on Twitter, maybe quotes that really allow people to have that sense of calm and to de-stress them. So take this, consider what is that journey that my clients who pay me go on, and then how can I give anybody who looks at my free content that same kind of experience? If you want more free tips for happy and successful self-employment, come over to youinspireme.co.uk. Leave your name and email and I can send lots more good stuff to you. Bye for now.